G'day YouTube, Turbo Tristan here, and today we're going to check out the Quickbitz workshop. Dyno some cars, and yeah, meet my mate Stix. And today we're outside Quickbitz, and we're going to take a workshop tour, hopefully the first of many. G'day Stix, how are you?
Good, yourself?
Good mate, good to see you.
Welcome to Quickbitz, man.
Thank you. Do you mind if I take a look around?
Have a look around, man, we'll show you around.
Awesome, thank you. All the bits and pieces that you could possibly need to set your car up. So,
the one-stop EFI shop, boys. Everything you need, we pretty much got it. So, car comes in for a tune. We've got from computers to wiring to sensors, connectors, fittings. So there's no downtime. It's the best part about this shop. Come in, get the thing sorted. Doesn't have to come off the dyno. We run out of fuel pump, we upgrade it on the dyno. Run out of injector, we upgrade it on the dyno. Heck, you need a new computer, we can do it on the dyno. So just make it nice and easy and yeah, have a look around. I hope you enjoy what we've got in the shop and some cool, interesting projects, that's for sure.
First BARRA of the day. Monster turbo on that one. Check this out. Got the super in the background. That thing's a beast. We'll show you more about that one day.
Car, then we've done something silly and put a V8 in it.
Oh well, I bet it still flies.
Yeah.
Like everything that comes out of here. What's this? We've got a GDR, yeah, Midnight GDRs. Purple. Yeah, so RB26. Yeah. What sort of turbo is that one?
Not sure, I think it's a 76, 75. I'm not too sure, I'm getting too confused these days. There's big hair dryers everywhere.
Turbos absolutely everywhere in this shop.
Yeah, you might remember this old girl, Darren from Cootamundra back in the day. Held the rear wheel drive record for a long time. This is version 3 now. So dry sump motor, bigger hair dryer, chrome oily front end. We've done the rear end. Deep into the 7s is the plan. So this thing went 8-9 years ago, like a lot of years ago, with the factory trans, factory ECU. So it's still a very hard achievement. The boys at NISSAN gave us a hand with it.
That's crazy. I remember Darren, the first time I met you was when you first brought Darren out.
Yes.
And blew everyone away.
Yeah, we sort of rocked up undercover with the hubcaps.
Biggest sleeper anyone's ever seen.
It was funny, you know, people were walking past laughing at the car and we're like, this is gold. You know, they just don't know what they're racing against. Old mate John Smith was probably a classic example with the Silvia. I smoked him hard and I don't think he was expecting it, but it's all good fun. We get good laughs and the car's awesome, mate. It's just, the cops don't pick on it.
No, they'll never pick it.
They don't care, mate. Just looks like a Commodore with wheels, someone that wants to belong.
When was the last time this one raced?
A couple years ago. So the guy that I sold the car to, my best mate, and now he drives my car for me. So
he's been he drives that one?
Yeah, he drives that. He's been a little bit sidetracked with that.
Wow.
But this year, we said it's Darren's year, we're going to get it going again.
What was its best time?
We went 8-0, I think it was, at Calder.
It's a beast. I remember seeing this and everyone, like you came with a reputation, like, oh, this guy builds them out of street cars, and you didn't disappoint because...
It was actually, all right, just to show you guys, so if you look into this intercooler, this is $178, mate. And that thing made 1,100 horsepower at the tyres. The car was built, when we went to Cootamundra, it cost me 10 grand. No, look, word of a lie. Yes, I've got a shop, so I've got a lot of bits and pieces lying around. But the engine was fairly mild. It was 10 grand. It was a 10 grand build. Everyone helped out and we built it on the budget. Like that intercooler shows you, it's only a $180 intercooler.
I remember the first time that I met you, you said you just knocked it together just for Cootamundra, yeah. And you just like had it ready on the truck.
I was actually quite surprised. So when we were doing a car like this, everyone's like, oh, you got to do your tail shaft, you got to do this, that. Man, we went 8.7 with a factory tail shaft, factory diff, everything was stocked. The only thing I did was change the front yoke to go into the gearbox, obviously, because we had a power glide trans. But after running 8.7, once we tried to go a little bit harder, turned it up, and only then we actually rotated the pumpkin on the axle tubes. Nothing else damaged. Like, we were amazed at how long the standard stuff actually lasts. Same with the center bearing. And actually, the two-piece shaft held amazingly good.
And it's all solid now, though.
Yeah, now it's all upgraded because we just don't want that stuff happening again.
No,
it just goes to show you can build quite a quick car on a budget. Yeah, it always had some power.
And like what's the goal?
1,000 horsepower at the tyres it always had.
And the goal on this setup?
Well, that turbochargers make, I think it's good for about 1,800, so I want to top that.
Max it out.
Max it out.
Just send it.
No point in having it on there.
Yep.
And then if we get greedy, we've got a kit of nitrous on top of that. And now there's faster and quicker cars. It's good. We've got some good competition. That MR2 is surprisingly quick, so
mate,
I want to build one.
Changing the game. People are jumping out of GDRs.
Yeah.
Just like me, out of GDRs into Honda's powered stuff because they're so
sometimes
quick.
Sometimes the four bangers are the best, mate. That's what I grew up on, four cylinders. My original car was an SR20 Corolla, and I've learned everything off them. And you know what? They're probably the best motor to learn off because they're so highly strung. You slip up, mate, that's it. Engine's gone.
Oh, that's how I started SRs.
So, yeah. They're
blowing rockers all the
that's
time.
That's right.
Yep.
We had a little on the board, we had lines, and every time we get the five scrub one, next one, we had like 13 engines we went through to learn what we can do and what we can't do.
They pop.
This is just a basic RB30, mildly built motor by CK Automotive, 3582 low. Oh, actually, no, this is a 3076 low mount. Gone for a bit of a different.
Little one.
A little one. This
little these days.
Yeah, it wants it real sharp on the factory exhaust manifold. It's a genuine turbo car, so I want to keep everything as stock as possible.
Yeah.
The excess throttle body, I suppose.
And then you've got,
LOL
747.
LOL 747. So this car's been an interesting one to tune. We did tune it many years ago, and it got sold, got bought by a new guy. I think it exchanged two owners, I could have. But it's been to a couple of different shops, and they've had things done to it. And now the new owner's like, I want you guys to redo it since you've done it originally. And we found a whole bunch of things wrong with it, and it's been driving us mad, and I'm finally starting to get on top of it now.
Well, from here, it looks pretty stock.
Yeah, it looks pretty stock.
Bit of a sleeper.
If you have a look here, man, there's a lot of big, ugly pipes everywhere.
Wow. You wouldn't pick that.
Precision 8285, currently at 27 PSI. The drama I got with this is they've put a power glide transmission in it, and it's the wrong converter. It's just way too loose. You hit the throttle straight to 5800. It's a factory canned engine, so it's not like it's going to go to 8. So 5800. We might rev it to 65, 700 RPM, not much window there. I'll do a quick pull on the dyno later, you guys can sort of see what I'm talking about. But,
and is this the graph while we got no noise?
Yeah, the graph's there you go. I was looking at fuel pressure because we got the fuel system hasn't been done correctly, and we're battling sky high fuel pressures. And surprising, it's even worse when it's cold. So that richened it right up on cold start. But that's what the dyno's for. It's put the cars on, diagnose all the issues, and see what we can do to make it better next time. So now he's going to take the car, he's going to tighten the converter. We've given him a few ideas what to do with the fuel system, bring that fuel pressure down. Might need to change the intercooler because this has actually got the Plasma Man first generation 800 horsepower intercooler, which is doing all right. It's made like that at the tyres, so it's doing okay.
So when I spoke to you the other day, you told me about you had this one in, and you said it was one of your baby cars, and it was only making 562 kilowatts at the wheel. So if that's a baby, I can't wait to see what else you've got lying around.
Oh, these BARRAs, the serious ones start at 1,000 sort of kilowatt at the wheel mark. Not bad for a cab engine, I'll tell you that.
We use these as taxis in Australia if you're watching from overseas.
Damn good taxi at that.
Alright, so Stix has jumped in the Falcon. He's going to do a pull just for us so you can see what one of his baby cars makes on the dyno. So I'll bring you around. Here it is. We've got the screen set up. Thank you. was that run there? 560?
Yeah, 560.
Far out.
Beautiful.
And that's a baby car. Look at that. Perfectly tuned. All the way. 560.2. Nice, believe that. This is why you want a BARRA, guys. Just perfectly flat. The power band is from 160 kilometers all the way up to 270 kilometers. All that usable power. That's crazy. Hopefully the Honda can do that one day.
But for a cab engine.
Awesome. So there you go. Hopefully we'll be seeing lots more videos of Stix's babies and all the big, huge horsepower cars that he has down here at Quickbitz. And yeah, we'll pop in from time to time, see what's going on, and bring you guys some videos. Let me know what you like in the comments, what you want to see, and also what you think about the BARRAs.
You're going to make sure it's all spot on if you're doing a Ford. Keep it simple, keep it basic, change what you have to. Don't change all this other shit around it, because it's just going to make the tuner's life hell.
Some pretty good recipes on how to build these now, and all over the States, you know, they're becoming like YouTube sensations, yeah. Internet sensations. Everyone wants to know about the BARRA because they don't have them overseas.
It's amazing that from the last drag week that they've got over there. Before then, they didn't really know much about BARRAs, and a few Aussies have taken their BARRAs up there, and now they've got BARRA group pages, and everyone's, I'm getting messages from my mates, and hey Stix, you know, what's this BARRA, how much power do we need to run? I'm like, wow, like these guys are starting to really do their R&D on them and looking at yep. what we use, and they're going to love playing with them, that's for sure. But just don't buy all of them, guys, because we still need some here. I keep blowing these things up all the time, need some spares.
Luckily, we've got plenty of taxis lying around.
Yeah. That's actually funny. The last one, the last motor, I found lying at the backyard from the scrap metal joint just down the road here.
No way.
The thing was mint, and he had it in the bin. I ripped it out, put it here, got a spare block. So, yeah.
That'll be punching out 1,000 horsepower in no time at all. Right. Yeah, I saw a Mercedes around the corner peeking around. You do those as well, Euros.
So, again. Other than playing with four cylinders, one of the four cylinders I was playing with back in the early day was a Mercedes.
No way.
My father's car, so.
Shoe on, we don't know how to open the bonnet because this is a full on top speed, land speed car. So it's every single part of it's been modified.
Yeah, you've got the Motec dash. It's got a full electronic controlled transmission, this one. We've got a controller from Europe. So this is going to be something fun to play with, and with, it's not paddle, but it's button shift.
No way.
Yeah. And it's got a lock up converter as well in the transmission, so you can get every last mile an hour you can out of it.
Yeah, this is insane.
It'll be a cool car, and he's doing twin turbo soon.
Wow.
So,
big, yeah. Big power, very high speed.
Yeah. And very sketchy.
Very sketchy.
So these were like president's cars back in the day, SL600. Very rare cars.
Yeah.
One of them came in the 500s with the V8.
Yep.
This one's got the V12, which is pretty much two six cylinders together.
Far out.
And actually use two six cylinder computers and control them as different engines.
Can't wait to see this on the dyno. Yeah. It'll be like an F1 car.
It sounds awesome. Let's see if we can start it.
No way. We're in for a treat if this starts. Oh, something's happening. Are ringing, so anyone who's watching this at home, hopefully don't have headphones in, because far out, that was loud and sounded
the owners
crazy.
Were actually happy just to hear it run, just to see what it sounds like.
Wow.
And that was enough for them. They were amazed after that. It sounds awesome, actually.
I've never heard anything like that.
Nah, nothing. You wouldn't expect it from a Merc engine.
Nah.
It's actually amazing how it sounds.
And the pipes came right out the back of the boot.
Yeah.
So
I think it's all designed to help assist air and help open the chute and all that sort of stuff.
Check out these pipes.
Yeah, so the chutes go in there and then they launch out.
So it's got its own catapults for the chutes.
Yeah. So this would be a cool one. So when we're dynoing, come around and make sure you've got your high quality earmuffs in.
Yeah, I'd love to get an invite to listen to this.
Yeah. Just another basic Evo.
Something different again. We got Mitsubishis, Mercedes, we've got Fords, we've got Supras.
This is a car. We haven't built this car. We're just putting the M-tron ECU on it. It did run 10s many, 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 many moons ago. But we all know Evo 3 gearboxes are glass. It's got a dog box in it, but I think the case is what lets them down.
These are my favourite shape.
Me too.
The Evo 3s. I love them. I learned to drive on one. And yeah, you're doing a lot with the M-tron stuff, aren't you?
Yeah, just started to get, look, we play with any computer. But lately there's been a lot of M-tron. People just like all the cool stuff that it can do. And unlike some other computer brands out there, it's all open, all unlocked. Do what you like. It's a great option, you know. So
yeah, hearing a lot about them, I don't know too much myself, but yeah, they're the talk of the town at the moment.
So this got M-tron, the Merc's got M-tron, the Ford's got M-tron. Then we've got the other cars, Haltech. So there's three Haltechs and then the Link as well. So whatever
everything
it is, mate, we tune it.
You tune it.
We're
all
not biased. Well, we are, but we tune everything.
Mr. Tune 'em all.
Peace out, guys. Cheers.
Awesome.